comparing NBA players to their counterparts. The NBA is a star-driven league. Even a team with the deepest bench typically will lose a series to a team that has more star players. If you look at the top teams in the league today, most of them are comprised of two star players, and the rest of the roster is made up of supporting players who play a certain role and have games that work well with the stars. For example, the top three teams in the NBA currently are the Los Angeles Lakers, the Los Angeles Clippers, and the Milwaukee Bucks. The Lakers have LeBron James and Anthony Davis, the Clippers have Kawhi Leonard and Paul George, and the Bucks have Giannis Antetokounmpo and Chris Middleton. Today, we will be looking at some of the top duos in the league and comparing the games and careers of each star on the team to the other. LeBron James and Anthony Davis. The first duo we will cover is arguably the best duo in the league, LeBron James and Anthony Davis. As it stands today, LeBron is widely considered the best player in the NBA, while Anthony Davis has a case for being considered a top 5 player in the league. Davis is by many considered to be the best teammate that LeBron has ever played with, which is high praise considering he has shared the court with Hall of Fame caliber players like Dwayne Wade, Chris Bosh, Ray Allen, Kyrie Irving, and Kevin Love, just to name a few. Davis is currently in his 8th season in the league. He was selected as the first overall pick of the 2012 draft. Throughout his young career, Davis has already proven himself as one of the best power forwards of all time talent-wise. He just needs to better bulk up his career accomplishments and resume. He has career averages of 24 points per game, 10.4 rebounds a game, 2.2 assists, 1.4 steals, and 2.4 blocks. In his rookie season, he made the All-NBA rookie team, although losing Rookie of the Year award to Damian Lillard. Davis has made 7 All-Star game appearances, and even won the All-Star MVP in the 2016-2017 season. He has made an All-NBA team 3 times in his career. Defensively, ever since he has entered the league, Davis has been touted as one of the best to do it. He is in constant contention to win Defensive Player of the Year on a yearly basis, despite not yet winning the award. He has made the All-Defensive team 3 times in his career, and led the league in blocks 3 times. During his time with the New Orleans Pelicans, Davis carried the team to the playoffs on 2 occasions, in the 2014-2015 season and in the 2017-2018 season. Davis has a chance to further bulk up his career resume this season, with his team being first in the Western Conference currently, and one of the favorites to win the title. Despite this, if Davis continues on his path to greatness even if he never wins a ring, he is a surefire Hall of Famer. As far as Davis's game goes, he is a great inside-out scorer. He has progressively begun to shoot more threes at a very solid rate, especially for his position. Over his career, he shoots 31.9% from 3. However, in the current season, he is shooting 33.5% on 3.5 threes per game. His inside scoring is nearly unstoppable, and he is a monster on the boards. As previously mentioned, he is one of the best defenders in the league on a yearly basis, and the best rim protector in the NBA. LeBron James has had one of the most decorated careers of any player in NBA history. He even has a case for being the greatest player of all time. He spent 17 seasons in the NBA with the Cleveland Cavaliers, Miami Heat, and Los Angeles Lakers. He was selected with the first overall pick of the 2003 draft, and in his rookie year, won Rookie of the Year award over players like Dwayne Wade, Carmelo Anthony, and Chris Bosh. James is a 16-time All-Star and 3-time All-Star Game MVP. He has won the regular season MVP award 4 times. He is a 3-time NBA champion, and in each of his championship wins, he was named Finals MVP. He has made an All-NBA team 15 times, an All-Defensive team 6 times. James also has the feat of carrying an awful Cleveland Cavaliers team to the NBA Finals in the 2006-2007 season, where he alone was not enough to defeat a prime San Antonio Spurs team. He led his team back from a 3-1 deficit in the 2016 NBA Finals against the Golden State Warriors, who had the best regular season record of all time. He made 8 consecutive NBA Finals appearances, and he won the regular season scoring title in the 2007-2008 season. Throughout his lengthy career, LeBron has averaged 27.1 points, 7.4 rebounds, 7.4 assists, 1.6 steals, and 0.8 blocks per game. LeBron, like Davis, is a much better inside scorer than outside. James is the best passing non-guard of all time, and has some of the best passing vision and basketball IQ that the game has ever seen. Though his defense has slipped as he has gone further in his career, he always finds a way to become one of the best defenders in the league during the playoffs. LeBron and Davis mesh perfectly together both on and off the court. With the two of them at the helm, the Lakers have some of the best chemistry in the league, and it is likely that we will see the two even win a championship together. Kawhi Leonard and Paul George. The next duo we will cover is the Los Angeles Clippers pairing of Kawhi Leonard and Paul George. Both are amazing two-way players, and they're in the prime of their career at the same time. They are a duo that we may see together for a long time. Kawhi was drafted 15th overall by the Indiana Pacers, the same team that also selected Paul George in the previous draft, meaning that we could have seen this duo play together with the Indiana Pacers. However, the Pacers traded Kawhi the night of the draft for George Hill. During his 9-year run in the NBA, Kawhi has played for the San Antonio Spurs, the Toronto Raptors, and the Los Angeles Clippers. He is a 4-time All-Star and a 1-time All-Star MVP. He has made 3 All-NBA teams and has been a part of 5 All-NBA defensive teams. He has won Defensive Player of the Year twice, and even led the league in steals in the 2014-2015 season. Kawhi has won a championship 2 times so far in his career, once with the San Antonio Spurs in the 2014-2015 season, and once with the Toronto Raptors in the 2018-2019 season. In both of his finals wins, Kawhi has been named Finals MVP. He has career averages of 18.6 points per game, 6.4 rebounds, 2.7 assists, 1.8 steals, and 0.7 blocks. After his victory in the finals against a banged-up Golden State Warriors team, many deemed Kawhi to be the best player in the NBA, even going into the 2019-2020 season. However, with the number of injuries and rest days that Leonard has taken this season, talk about him being the best in the league has seemed to die down. Paul George was selected 10th overall in the 2010 NBA Draft. During his career, he has played for the Indiana Pacers, the Oklahoma City Thunder, and the Los Angeles Clippers. In his 9 years in the league, George has been a 6-time All-Star, a 5-time member of an All-NBA team, a 4-time member of an All-Defensive team, and he led the league in steals in the 2018-2019 season. Over his career, he has averaged 19.9 points per game, 6.4 rebounds, 3.3 assists, 1.7 steals, and 0.4 blocks. Looking at the career stats of the two, it is clear to see how identical they are as players. They have nearly the same type of playing style, being players who can score from anywhere on the court. However, both especially thrive in mid-range shooting. But possibly the best aspect of both their games is their two-way ability. Both players are incredible defenders, and in the case of Kawhi, he has been recognized as the best defender in the league in 2 separate seasons. Both players have made multiple all-defensive teams in their careers, and as a result, make it very difficult for any wing player to get an offensive game going when they are playing against Leonard, George, and the Clippers. Luka Doncic and Kristaps Porzingis. The next duo we will cover is the Dallas Mavericks' young pairing of Luka Doncic and Kristaps Porzingis. Both spent time playing overseas before making it to the NBA, rather than going the traditional route of playing college basketball for 1-4 years, then making the jump to the NBA. Both were selected with a top 5 pick in each of their respective drafts, and have made the transition from EuroLeague basketball to the NBA flawlessly. Porzingis was selected 4th overall in the 2015 NBA draft by the New York Knicks. In his 4 years in the league, Porzingis has played 3 seasons with the New York Knicks, and is currently in his first season with the Dallas Mavericks. He is a 1-time All-Star, and was part of the 2015-2016 All-Rookie team. Throughout his career, Porzingis averages 18.1 points per game, 7.6 rebounds, 1.4 assists, 0.7 steals, and 2 blocks. Porzingis has established himself as one of the best rim protectors in the league, and is always a tough matchup for opposing big men. He has been one of the leaders in the revolution of the stretch 4-5, being a big man that can stretch the floor and shoot threes. Along with him standing 7'3" at the power forward spot, he is a matchup nightmare for almost any power forward. Luka Doncic is one of the best young players that the game has to offer. In only 2 seasons, he has taken the league by storm, and has already established himself as one of the best in the game. He was selected 3rd overall in the 2018 draft by the Atlanta Hawks, and would be traded on draft night to the Dallas Mavericks. Luka has been in the league for 2 seasons, yet already has quite a few prestigious awards attached to his name. He is a 1-time All-Star, and won the 2018-2019 NBA Rookie of the Year. Early in the 2019-2020 season, Luka also had his name in the race of even winning MVP, although those have begun to subside as Giannis and LeBron have taken their games to another level this regular season. Throughout his career, Luka has averaged 24.4 points, 8.5 rebounds, 7.1 assists, 1.1 steals, and 0.3 blocks. Luka and Kristaps are both players who can score from anywhere on the court. With Porzingis being such a skilled shooter, it opens the floor to Doncic to be able to have an easier time driving to the basket. Out of the two, Porzingis is a much more skilled defender. However, Luka still has plenty of time to improve on that facet of his game. With the two Dallas stars being so young, we could see them keep progressing together, and inevitably win themselves a championship before it is all said and done. Giannis Antetokounmpo and Chris Middleton. The final duo we will cover is the Bucks pairing of Giannis Antetokounmpo and Chris Middleton. Both are all-star caliber players and have brought the Bucks the best record in the regular season this year. Giannis was drafted 15th overall in the 2013 NBA draft. Giannis has played 7 seasons so far, with all of them being with the Bucks. He's established himself as one of the best players in the NBA. He won last year's MVP and is on a golden path to winning it again this season. He's a 4-time All-Star, has made an All-NBA team 3 times in his career, and has made an All-Defensive team twice. His career averages are 20 points per game, 8.9 rebounds, 4.3 assists, 1.2 steals, and 1.3 blocks. He is one of the league's best defenders, as well as being one of the most impossible to stop players on the interior, as well as in the fast break. Chris Middleton was drafted with the 39th overall pick of the 2012 NBA draft by the Detroit Pistons. He only spent a single season with the team, and has spent the rest of his career with the Bucks. Middleton is a 2-time All-Star, and one of the better perimeter defenders and 3-point shooters in the league. Throughout his career, he averages 16.3 points per game, 4.6 rebounds, 3.3 assists, 1.3 steals, and 0.3 blocks. While their games are very different from each other, they still have great chemistry on the court, and their games complement each other very well. Giannis is one of the best in the league when it comes to driving and finishing at the basket, and as a result of this, when he drives to the hoop, many players will help over and try to stop the ball. Because of Giannis also being such a skilled playmaker and passer, he can oftentimes find wide open snipers like Middleton for easy threes. Final thoughts. In conclusion, there are countless skilled duos in the NBA, and when comparing them, there is oftentimes a Batman and there is a Robin. The duo cannot typically be successful unless both players accept and play into their roles. As we have seen today, the most skilled duos in the league all have games that complement each other and lead to great team success. Thank you for watching, and make sure to subscribe to Up Next Sports for more basketball content similar to this.